okay? So the percentage income here is known as the cost of equity, okay? And that cost of equity, now I know this may sound scary again, cost of equity, wow. Don't worry about it, it's just MBA bullshit. It just means that the amount of percentage that this third company should offer you so that it can be a competitive investment against this and this. Okay, now how does the formula come in here? Well, this cost of equity is written as this, K sub E. All right, now your professor or many professors might have might use different letters instead of K sub E. They might say R sub E or E or letter C instead. I don't know. They might have their own. But in the end, they're just talking about the same thing, which is cost of equity. Okay? Now, this KE is part of this formula here, as you can see. So now you can see where this formula comes into play. Because if you want to compute the percentage here, the percentage here that this company needs to offer you, then you need to find out K sub E. And in order to find out what is K sub E, you now use this formula over here. Or in other words, you now use all of this bullshit over here that you see. Okay? So that is what that formula is used for. Alright? Oh, by the way, CAPM is the name of the model. It is not a variable that you find in here. Okay? Because you might be saying, where on earth is the CAPM here? I don't see any letter C. I don't see any letter A or P or M. CAPM is just the name of this whole concept. It is the name of this model, or the name of this mathematical formula. Okay? Alright. Now, another thing I want to point out is that this K sub E, are these two variables, a letter K and the letter E, or is this just one variable? Okay? Now, this is just one variable, okay? Do not get confused and think, oh, these are two variables, letter K and a letter E. Okay, I used to make that mistake before when I was bad in math once upon a time, okay? But thankfully not anymore, because I know how to see things in a very visual way, and that's what I'm sharing with you now, okay? Now, when you use this formula, you'll be able to find out K sub E, which can be or will be expressed as a percentage like this, so that you can find the right or the correct percentage to put over here. Let's just say that after you've done this computation, let's just say that you have K sub E and you had the figures inputted. You inputted the figures or the numbers here, and after all this computation, you came out with the figure that K sub E equals 8.6% as the cost of equity. Now, this is just an example because we didn't do the actual computation here in this problem. I just want you to see how to use this K sub E. So after doing this computation, you find out that K sub E equals 8.6%. Then, now you know that the cost of equity is 8.6%. And you can go back to the previous problem here, and now you can literally write over here 8.6%. Okay? So now you know that the risk-free rate is 2%, the systematic risk rate, or the medium risk rate, is 8%. And how about for this higher risk? How much should be offered to you to make this investment just as attractive as this and this? Then, this investment should offer you 8.6%. Okay? So, it's as simple as that. Now, the question here, I just want to pose you a question. Does this mean that if you invest in that investment and the higher risk investment, does this mean that your profit will be 8.6%? Does it mean that? Let's say this, you come out with a figure, K sub E equals 8.6%. What does that mean? Okay, does it mean that, so I already said it. Does it mean that you'll earn 8.6%? Okay, the answer is no. All right, it does not mean you will earn 8.6%. What this means is that if you put your money in that higher risk investment that you see here, okay, if you put your money in this higher risk investment that you see here, then that means that you should demand 8.6% from them, from this company, in return. You should demand at least 8.6%. Because if they offer you less than 8.6%, maybe they might offer you 8%, then you can tell them to go to hell. You'll say, what? You're going to give me 8% with this higher risk? If you are going to give me 8% with this higher risk, I'd rather put my money here with medium risk, and I'll also get 8%. Okay? Or, if this company says, I'll give you 2%, you'll say, go to hell. You tell them to go to hell, because you can put your money here and earn 2% with zero risk, or you can put your money here and earn 8%, which is even higher than 2%, and get only medium risk. It would not make logical sense to put your money here if you get only 8%, and it would not make logical sense for you to put your money here if you get only 2%, because you are taking much more risk, and so it is only fair and proper that this company should offer you a higher expected profit of at least 8.6% or higher.